Hey guys, my name is Scoby. Today I'm going to be showing you how to open up a new Premiere Pro project file on an older version of Premiere Pro. So when you try to open up a new Premiere Pro project file, you might get this error in Premiere Pro saying this project was saved in a newer version of Premiere Pro and cannot be opened in this version. I'm going to be showing you step by step how to fix this. We will not need to use another PC. We will not need to re-export as an XML file because that's given me a lot of trouble in the past. In this case, all we need is the Premiere Pro project file, and I'm going to be showing you how to fix it right now. So I will mention before jumping into this, you are going to need 7-Zip. 7-Zip is a free extraction software. I'll leave a link to this in the description down below. Download and install the version that most suits for your PC and get that installed. After this, we're just going to be affecting our project. So the first thing I'll be doing is making a copy of the project that is from the new version of Premiere Pro. Now, this is really just a backup in case you need to go back to the original file. But in this case, we're just going to be copying and pasting by clicking Control and C and Control and V, or Command and C and Command and V if you're on a Mac. And we're going to be using our copied version and we're going to rename it to Downgrade. Now, the reason we do this is just so we know which project we're working with and we won't have to worry about seeing copies and stuff. And we're going to be naming this project to Downgrade just so we know which project we're going to be using. Once you have this done, we're going to be right-clicking, we're going to be going to 7-Zip, and we're going to be extracting here. Now, we're going to be extracting the files from our actual Premiere Pro project, and you're going to be left with two files from this. You're going to be left with an actual Downgrade file, and we're going to be left with the actual Premiere Pro project. So in this case, we're going to be focusing on the actual Downgrade file, and we're going to be opening up this Downgrade file with any text editor you want. In this case, I'm going to be opening up with Notepad, but of course, any text editor you want to use in your case is fine. We're going to open this up. Once you open up the Downgrade file, you're going to notice we're going to have thousands and thousands of lines of code. In this case, we're looking for the fourth section. Sections are broken up with these brackets. You can see that there's a triangle bracket at the start and finish. We're looking for the fourth section. So we have 1, 2, 3, and then we have the fourth section here. I'm going to be coming over on it slightly. And in our fourth section, at the very end of the string, we're going to notice that there's a version equals, and inside this version, there's going to be a number inside the two curly brackets. We're going to be changing this version number to 1, and we're going to be saving the file by clicking Control and S, or we're going to go to File and Save depending on whatever editor you're using, and we want to X this file off. So now we're going to be bringing this Downgrade file into 7-Zip to add it to an archive. So what you want to do is right click the file, hover over 7-Zip, and we're going to be clicking Add to Archive. From here, you can rename your Downgrade file if you wish. I'm going to keep it named Downgrade for now. And we're going to be setting the archive format to gzip. And you want to keep all other settings on this actual file to be exactly the same as mine right now. Once you've all these set up, we're going to be clicking OK. So once you've this method complete, we're going to be left with a downgrade.gz file. We're going to change the extension from a .gz to a .Premiere Pro project file. So what you want to do is double click in here to rename it. And we're going to be naming it PRPROJ, which is a .Premiere Pro project extension. You want to click Enter to allow this. You may get a warning saying this file may become unusable, but what you want to do is click OK, click Yes, and your project will change to a Premiere Pro project file. So now if we try to open up our new made Downgrade file that has the number 2 in the brackets because it's the second Premiere Pro project, you will notice that our Premiere Pro project will open, and we will have to remake a file because this is from an older version, so we're going to have to make it from a new version of Premiere Pro. So give the file whatever name you want, so you can rename it remade version, and you can give it a date or whatever you want to call it. Click Enter. In this case, the other PC I was using this project on had a different type of GPU, so it's just saying it's going to switch to the different type. So you want to click OK, and your project will open. I'm not going to bother relinking any of these files in this case because it'll take too long, so I'm just going to click Cancel. But you'll see the project will open up fully. I have all the titles and all the bins of my original video. I also have all my sequences, and everything is set up in the correct order. So as you can tell, everything works. The sequences are still here. All the files are still in the correct order on the actual timeline. The only thing is I'm not going to relink the actual files right now, but of course they're really easy to relink. And this even works across OSs. The actual new version of Premiere Pro I was using was from a Mac version, but all you have to do is do this method and it will work across OSs. It'll work across versions and it works really, really well. But anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this tutorial, be sure to drop a like, subscribe if you're new, check out the other videos on the channel. I'm also going to leave my PayPal link down below if you want to support the channel, if you find these videos helpful. I'd really appreciate it. It would really support me. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, as always, keep it saucy. Peace.